This is CNN Breaking News.
All right, so we roll on. You're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin, live here in our nation's capital, and we've got some breaking news now. CNN has learned that in recent weeks, federal prosecutors in New York have been trying to interview executives in the Trump Organization. This is according to people familiar with this whole thing. It is another sign of the growing legal troubles that the president could face outside of the special counsel's investigation, the Russia probe. So let's go straight to CNN Politics and business correspondent Cristina Alesci with these breaking details. And so what do you know?
Well, we know that federal prosecutors in New York are now seeking interviews with top Trump Organization executives. Look, Brooke, this intensifies the fears that the bigger threat to the president and his business may come from New York prosecutors and not Mueller's team. What we do know is that the New York prosecutors have been looking into two specific areas. One is the campaign finance, a possible campaign finance violation in connection to reimbursements that the Trump Organization made to Michael Cohen for those hush money payments. The other one is financial abuses tied to donations to the inaugural committee. Those are the two specific areas, but we don't know if there's another area or if there are multiple other areas, and we don't know if prosecutors are asking for interviews with these executives for those two inquiries or possibly something else. We also don't know the extent of these interviews and how serious they are. We don't believe that there were subpoenas issued, so this could be an informal interview, and this could be just a matter of prosecutors, what we call checking the box or making sure they didn't miss anything and not necessarily looking for something new. But one thing is clear, these executives are senior people who have been with the organization for a long time. They know a lot of personal information about the president and his operations, and this could go on for quite some time, perhaps even beyond the Mueller investigation.
Mm-hmm. Cristina, thank you so much for the setup and the reporting. So let's analyze all of what you just laid out. CNN legal analyst Carrie Cordero, a former counsel to the Assistant Attorney General for National Security, is here, and former National Security Prosecutor Joseph Moreno. So, all right, she just laid out a lot, but what I'm hearing is some very senior people within the Trump Organization, who obviously would know a lot about this president, would know a lot about his finances, are being questioned by some top prosecutors in the state of New York. What could they be looking for?
Well, you know, one point is that in addition to the people who now we're learning are being interviewed, there have already been two major figures in the Trump Organization who are already cooperating, and that's the accountant, Alan Weisselberg,
yes,
and that's Michael Cohen,
yes,
who is involved. So
one has immunity and one's going to prison.
Exactly. And so both of them have already been providing information, and it could be that some information that they've been providing for some period of time
is leading to leads.
And now what we're seeing is standard investigative procedure. We're seeing subpoenas being issued with respect to the inaugural committee.
Yes.
And now with this new reporting, we're seeing more witnesses interviewed. And Joe, I'm sure you agree, this is standard investigative technique when we're talking about subpoenas and witness interviews.
It is. But, you know, the danger here to the Trump Organization and to the president himself is what we don't know. Right? We've been talking about the Mueller probe for almost 2 years. We have a general idea of where he's going based on the cases he's brought. We know his mandate.
Do we?
Well, we have a general, we think we do. I mean, yeah, anything is possible.
Yeah.
But we know there are some safeguards as to he has to report certain things. And we don't know what's going on in New York. And, yeah, and a lot of us thought when Michael Cohen's office was raided last year, that's the threat, because they could go anywhere.
Yes.
And the Southern District of New York, they are known to be fiercely independent,
yes,
fiercely aggressive. They will go where the evidence leads them.
So it's SDNY. You mentioned the inaugural committee looking into potential crimes, including like wire fraud, you know, straw donors, conspiracy. That's SDNY. The lead prosecutor on that case was also one of the lead prosecutors, Michael Cohen. And it's also SDNY doing now questioning these folks within Trump org. So with regard to the inaugural committee and donations, why is conspiracy perhaps the most damning crime?
Well, conspiracy is the overall on the special counsel's case. That's their theory of the case. With respect to the inaugural committee, that potentially invokes campaign finance laws. There could be a conspiracy to violate campaign finance laws. So a conspiracy charge usually goes along with some other charge. The special counsel's overall theory of their case is conspiracy to defraud the United States to affect the 2016 election. And
yes,
then there's a whole bunch of other computer crime and other crimes that go along with that. The inaugural committee, where that ties to, is one big question is, did foreign money come into that inaugural committee? We know that actually one specific instance of when it did, there was an individual charged who pled back in August, Sam Patton, who they laid out actually did facilitate foreign Ukrainian oligarch money coming into the inaugural committee. That's one instance, and it was never revealed who the actual American was who served as the straw man. So it's not surprising to me that there was a subpoena to the inaugural committee looking for more information about whether or not there was more foreign money that came into it. And the other thing, just one other point, there's no time limit to these investigations.
This could go on.
In other words, these investigations, everyone's always on the political side. When is it going to end? Yeah. When's a special counsel's investigation going to end? There's no requirement anywhere that these investigations have a timestamp on them.
Sure.
They will run their full course.
Sure, sure. Which means that while Mueller may say, I'm done, the SDNY with all the tentacles could go on for quite a while. My last question for you, sir, just on, so people understand, so the reporting details how the SDNY is looking for paperwork related to, quote, the possibility of donations made by foreign nationals, which Carrie was mentioning. So, but it's only a crime if it was done with the knowledge that the foreign contributions were illegal. So they had to know, right?
Right.
That's what would make it the crime.
True. Okay, so what's the point of contributing to inauguration campaign?
Currying favor.
It's to see and be seen, right? You're making a donation in large amounts, preferably to the candidate, to go to events, to go to the inauguration, to go to the parade, to go to the balls. That's why. So the idea that you would get large amounts of money, over $100 million, and be able to say with a straight face, well, I don't really know where it came from, that's going to be a very hard argument to make.
Okay. Joe and Carrie, thank you very much.
Thank you.